Hi, this is Kiri, the tantric vegan. I was pondering how I have grown in the last few years, and one of those ways is that I have finally, well, I wouldn't say learned, I finally know how to get in touch with the way I feel. Now, this has been a long, long journey. It involved a lot of work, a lot of inner reflection and self-inquiry, and accessing a lot of pain that I was holding within myself and carrying around, a lot of baggage that I had. This is really a little bit connected with the fact that I'm autistic, but very much connected with the fact that my mother has narcissistic personality disorder. And I finally went no contact with my mother and my sister, who are both narcissists, a year ago. And although I've been very low contact most of my life, I feel like going no contact, like nothing at all. I told them how I felt and I wanted to be left alone, and then I haven't actually, I've had contact with them once because they have been doing what's called hoovering, trying to get me back into their lives, and I had to be quite, for me, quite honest with them because I've always been too scared to tell the truth to either of them, because I've been so bullied and abused by them that I was very frightened to stand my own ground and to be assertive. So I feel like distancing myself has really allowed me to grow and to, you could say, to do the final polishing that I needed on this personal growth journey of really knowing how I feel and being in touch with that, because it was like there was a disconnect there. And it's not hard to see why when we look at the kind of abuse we suffer, particularly the scapegoat daughter of a narcissistic mother, where I wasn't allowed to have any feelings. I was punished if I felt anything. The way I was punished was sometimes physical. Sometimes she would lash out of me and smack me very hard, like would leave a hand mark. But mostly it was psychological. And the damage from that is very, very deep, because obviously we experiencing that our whole lives. And so I guess as, oh, sorry, the color's going. I don't know what's happening with that. So the weather's changing outside. I think as a kind of self-preservation or coping mechanism, we learn to just shut down the way that we feel, because we learn very quickly that actually it's dangerous. It's dangerous to have our own feelings, to have our own opinions, and to be strong in our sense of self in any way, because our narcissistic mother is viewing us as an extension of herself or her ego. She's not seeing us as a separate being who deserves to be nurtured, to grow into our own sense of self and to develop a healthy sense of self-love and self-care. It's not about that at all for the narcissistic mother. She sees us as an extension who's there to serve her, to make her feel better because of her wounds, which she has developed from her childhood. Because these people, narcissistic people, are deeply wounded, very, very deeply wounded and very damaged, but it's quite sad because they are in denial of that. I would say a lot of them suffer from depression, but they very seldom really acknowledge that or start to look below the surface and understand why they like to just project their wounds or their pain outward or their pain and anger, you could say, outward onto the world or whoever is around them. Particularly in my case, being the scapegoat daughter, I had a lot of that projected onto me, and that is very damaging. So I learned very quickly to, it served me better as a child to walk on eggshells, all the colors coming back again, to walk on eggshells and really put the way I felt or my wants and needs on a back burner. In fact, I wasn't allowed to want anything. This was another thing I've had to really work hard on, is like, what do I even really want? Because I remember very distinctly being told throughout my childhood, I want doesn't get. Now, my sister was treated very differently to me. She was the golden child, and she has ended up a full-blown narcissist. So I've gone no contact with her as well, both of them a year ago at the same time. Although my sister hasn't really been in my life for decades, my mother triangulated our relationship so severely that, well, there just was no relationship there at all. And I think my sister just realized very early on that she gained brownie points for being abusive to me. My mother liked that. So yeah, it was really coming from both of them right throughout my life. I only have one sibling, a sister who's 5 years older than me. So I think going completely no contact, but also actually YouTube has been an incredible resource of knowledge regarding narcissistic personality disorder. Although I knew from my early 20s that my mother had this, because I used to like reading psychology books, and I recognized all the forms of abuse that I'd endured throughout my childhood or throughout my whole life. It was very clear because they seemed to follow a very specific type of forms of abuse, and it was very clear that I was a scapegoat. And knowing that now, I think the scapegoat is the one who's best off. I feel a lot of compassion for my sister because she's so trapped in the lie. I don't know if she's ever going to, or she can't really allow the truth. It's like in some part of her, she must know the truth, but she can't ever allow herself to acknowledge that truth because it's too deeply ingrained in the whole family dynamic. She's married with children, and my narcissistic mother plays a big role in her life. Although she lives in another country, my mother spends a lot of time with her every year. And I feel as a scapegoat, I was much better off because I knew from a young age that I was very, very damaged and broken, and that I felt like I needed help. And I have read extensively and done a lot of work on myself regarding this. But most of my growth has really been in the last few years, because I managed to gain some sort of acknowledgement of how I feel and my needs and how to meet them. But it's really only the last few years. And I think part of the catalyst for that was when I was very ill, my carer quite clearly has narcissistic personality disorder. And that was actually really helpful to me because it enabled me to see the sort of pattern of the relationships I was forming, because I continuously seemed to repeat this pattern. It was like there was something the universe was showing me and I wasn't seeing it, and he finally allowed me to see that actually he wasn't causing my pain. My pain was already there. He was really triggering my pain, and it allowed me to do a lot of research when I was bedridden online. And there are a lot of YouTubers who have a lot of good advice. I have a playlist where I've put some videos in the heading of narcissistic personality disorder or narcissism, because I've found a lot of people with a lot of helpful information who enabled me to really see a lot of what was going on in my relationship dynamics friends and lovers and family, and what was happening within myself. So I would say that right now I feel like I am really in touch with the way I feel. I'm sure that this is going to blossom even further, because I do feel like it's a blossoming. I really finally, at the age of over half a century, feel like I've blossomed into the person that I was always meant to be. I feel liberated. I feel like a massive big weight is off my back. I feel okay to be me. I feel like I'm healing from all the criticism and this feeling I had inside me my whole life, that I was inherently wrong and bad because I'd been told that all my life. That was one of the ways I was abused. And so there was a lot of self-sabotage going on there, because I didn't feel I was worth anything or worth it. And so, yeah, I've done a lot of healing with all of these things, and my family constantly tries to hoover me in. My mother now has my aunt working as her flying monkey to try and hoover me in. But I have said there, I want my space. I don't really want to be in contact with her either. Although I've always loved my aunt and my cousins, I feel like she's working for my mother. My interests are not her goal. Like, she clearly doesn't care about me. She's just doing my mother's bidding. If I won't communicate with my mother, she's trying to get my aunt to do the job. And I've had to, it's very upsetting, because I particularly get hoovered in when I'm feeling vulnerable. And particularly, it's happened around my birthday and around Christmas. And those are the times where it is really hard and traumatic and depressing when we are isolated and ostracized from our families. It's a very painful situation to be in, because there's a knowing that they're all together. But to be honest, I wouldn't want to be there with them in that big fat lie, because I know how I always felt very uncomfortable within that dynamic. Part of me kind of, it's almost like I'm wanting something that was never really there anyway. Doesn't make it any less painful, but the pain is getting better over time. It's getting easier and easier for me, because I'm blossoming and I feel so much better within myself. And I feel less and less like I want to. I feel really strongly like I want to avoid any sort of an abusive situation, because I'm feeling like I'm really developing self-love, and that I want to grow in that. And that is the way I am going to live a life of fulfillment and well-being. It's never going to be from outside myself. It's going to be from the way I feel about myself within. And when I say myself, I don't mean the ego self. I mean my well-being in terms of my being, my beingness, you could say. So my heart goes out to anyone else who is in this situation. I know how painful it is. So bless you all and be peace.